Stevie J sucks.
Turn it off now.
So what are you playing?
I'm taking a 2-week hiatus. I was dealing with a back issue. Got that rectified. You know, it's a hip issue. And I came back too soon. So now it's like, no, I gotta wait. So I'm gonna wait a couple weeks and see how it goes. But I play with the Gentlemen's Club.
Oh.
So we don't play till 8.
Gotcha.
But I work in like dirt. I live in Algonquin. I'm not going all the way home, but I'm going all the way back. And I still want to be involved because I like watching. And what else am I going to sit at home and do nothing?
I live right in the middle of those two podcasts. I'm right by Kelsey and 22.
Oh, shit, yeah. Pass it every day. Pretty much pass it every day. Because I go two ways to work, depending on if I want to, you know, see the river and stuff. I'll go Algonquin to the road. I'll go that way to, you know, 14 and 22. And then sometimes I'll take a boat from the Lake Cook, and then Lake Cook all the way to Gila, and then left on the road. It's my usual Monday or Wednesday. I usually get one a week here. I always tell people, I say, it's decent. It's not bad. It fills the void. That's what I tell people. It fills the void. Yeah, actually, they have a good selection. It's all sitting out there. Yeah, Rocco. I don't know if you know Rocco. He was playing with us. He worked over at Des Plaines. He parked his buggy in Des Plaines, but he played with us. Well, then this was coming open, and he applied. He got it. He's doing a good job. He's still, his feet are still getting wet. You know, still wet and trying to figure out the ins and outs of it. But I think he's doing a pretty good job. Yeah, he's been green. He's playing second.
Yeah. I played golf with him. He got a membership with Tail.
Oh, really?
Yeah. It's $30 to golf as a guest.
Really? So with the membership that he bought, does he not have to pay? He pays one thing up front, and then he can play unlimited?
Correct. Or whatever the restrictions are.
Or you can't play on
green.
Saturday or Sunday or something.
You can't have,
right.
Or you can't have a reserved one, but he didn't get the top one. That's the best. The thing is like every now and then they'll just like, can you
Let's
play
move over there?
Can you play?
You look in the mirror. Hold on, let me check. That's how I am.
Can you like, hold on, I'm gonna watch. I mean, if I ask my business partner, just
to
make sure he's gonna be there.
And then,
nothing I can't handle, of course.
Yeah, well, right, because I got my phone, so.
Yeah. So, yeah, other than that, my kids are cranking up the grandbabies.
Oh, good.
I had, my son had their first one.
Oh, wow.
That had to be tough to raise it. And it's a new one.
Oh, really?
So, I've only seen it in person twice.
Oh, wow.
And my daughter, who just got a house in the past.
Oh, nice.
She had purchased one in March.
Okay.
And then my son and his wife from Seattle had their second one 2 weeks ago.
Wow. Congratulations.
So, yeah.
Jesus.
Yeah.
So, to go back with that, do you have to do anything now? Any maintenance or anything you have to?
I have to stand, I think 6 months or something. Get a scale. That's clear. I got my foreskin 2 years later. That's clear. But here's the thing. They took it out. They already did a scan beforehand, and there was nothing in it. But they couldn't do like a legit biopsy. They did a biopsy. That is, that's only 1.9% chance of being onset.
So now, was there any restrictions on eating and stuff for a while?
Only for 2 weeks.
Oh, really?
Only for 2 weeks. That was really wild. And for 8 weeks, I took like a high power acid reducer, like just heating it down because of the whole thing. Plus, where they dug out, it looked like they had to scrape a little bit of the stuff. But they cure with acid, right? So as long as they wasn't drinking. That was fine. But 2 weeks after, I mean, I went out and played out with the band I played with every 2 weeks after I was done, they
called
me. That's awesome. I believe.
Yeah.
So, I just changed my diet a little bit, elective people, because of the movement.
Right.
Customers that you make the most, right. Keep that. And I'm a relationship salesman. I mean, I don't do ones and zeros, right? Right. I have the people that work for me to do that. So I just manage the project as if that's the business.
Right, right.
I can do that until the day I drop dead.
Yep.
Thank you.
I like him. Who's playing role for you? Think of like, how's he holding up physically?
Good.
Yeah.
He's some weight.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, Dave Shields. He's drunk.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Diabetes scare or
something.
TSR. I got the TSR 3 driver.
Oh,
I got the 3 and the 5 wood. And then I got the T300 irons and all the bulky blenders.
Okay. Yeah, I got fitted for a new driver this winter. I got the Stealth.
Yep.
And then 3 years ago, I got fitted for an iron and I got the blenders.
Yep.
I got the Project X shafts.
Yep.
Oh.
Yeah, I went to graphite shafts for mine.
That's
fine.
Yeah.
I had old paper cut alloy.
Nice.
Couldn't turn them.
Right.
And then it was like, whoa. My bag weighs a third of what it used to.
Yep.
I'm over swinging these now. I took a while to use them. I'll never need a glove again.
I gotta actually get my butt regret. Iron Spot Champions, Club Champions.
Yes.
And then my driver, I went to PGA.
Yeah.
It was, I like the PGA better. I think I got raped. I got raped at Club Champions.
I went to Golf Galaxy. I was going and wanting to get a Callaway one before the AI. What was the name of the same thing, same year the Stealth?
Oh, yeah.
Yes,
I know. I know. I can picture. I can't.
I was going to swing the triple diamond, right? Nice.
Oh,
yeah. So I'm swinging the Paradigm. I like it, but the guy's like, you know why you're so nice? I'm a bullhead's carbon fiber. Getting $600 for plastic. He's like, well, we can look at timeless. They're titanium. Yeah, but I've always heard that the backup timeless was getting so precise, getting the dollars. He's like, let's give it a shot. Gave me that one, and I just put the right, got a hazardous shaft and effort. Yeah, okay, I'll take the other two because I have my longest iron that went to 5.
Okay.
I use the 5 nut.
Right, yeah.
And that's just like,
yep,
nice and soft.
Oh, yeah,
and I still get it longer.
What's happening?
So me, you, my brother, and Steve Grass. That'll be a good one.
We're gonna play Friday at 3:10.
I'll see. Playing Wednesday, Steve Wilson.
Okay. supposed to go Thursday to Mount Prospect, but I think Thursday's going to be the bad one. We don't have to talk for some reason. Yeah, I don't think they can get it over 3 days. I'll let you know.
Okay.
How's the course?
That's okay.
Yeah.
Thank you. Thank you.
Because they asked me, is he coming to play?
Oh, well.
Nothing to be kind of fault. Nothing to be sorry about.
Another hip customer.
Thank you.
I love when the GM starts up the beginning of the pre-draft season saying, yeah, we're not going to give up too many. We're not going to give up too much cap space. We're not going to do too much with our draft or trades or anything. I saw a point in my life when the Darts would be in last year. It was kind of tricky. I've been treating myself to watching some playoff hockey this year. This is one of these last 14 games we've played really well. No close games. I think I've been treating myself.
Yeah. Thank you. I'm here. If there's money, you can't do it. What's up, Brady?